Time for 5 good minutes with ESPN NBA analyst Brian Windhorst, and certainly, Wendy, a lot of things to get to this week. A historic moment. We've got the trade deadline right around the corner, but we have to start with LeBron James. As Tuesday night, he became the all-time leading scorer in NBA history, passing Kareem. We knew it was a matter of time, Brian, but, you know, to do it on the home floor the way that he did, you know, I heard you kind of in pregame talking about on ESPN, they were going to feed him the ball. They did. Just where did last night rank for you as far as moments in the NBA? You obviously know LeBron so well, the importance of this to him and the historical impact of him becoming the greatest scorer in NBA history.
Yeah. After the 2016 championship, I'll tell you that probably the fifth after his championships. But it'll be the first thing he's credited for. Like when he's introduced, he'll be introduced as scoring champion, four-time champion, four-time MVP, two-time All-Star MVP. I don't know. For some reason, everybody values the postseason, but this means so much because it's an iconic record in sports. And I actually, I'm going to call on the Cavs to hang a banner or do some commemoration because the majority of the points came in Cleveland. And I honestly think that you can't honor LeBron enough in Cleveland. And, you know, the statue and whatever they name after him might have to wait till after they're actually playing against him. I get that. This is something they can done right now. Pat Riley would hang a banner. Pat Riley's probably been thinking of hanging a banner to commemorate. I mean, in Miami, they hang banners if you win a gold medal in the Olympics because, you know, they're proud of it. And so I think, you know, I don't know why the Cavs should recognize it, but he played 11 years, 11 of his years, the majority of his points are in a Cavs uniform. The Cavs are a humongous part of that record. There's no reason why they shouldn't, you know, honor him and frankly, take ownership of the record. All-time greatest scorer in history is a Cav. Okay. He did it as a Laker. He's a Cav. It's not like, you know, he only played 3 years in Cleveland. He's not a Heat. He's a Cav. So, I highly encourage that when LeBron comes back next year, that the Cavs have something to honor him and hopefully something that's not just for that night. Hopefully, I mean, I suggest a banner, but if they want to do something else, fine. They don't want to hang a banner, but put LeBron James' name on a banner, put his number of points in Cavs, put his accomplishments. There, I said it.
Well, LeBron, aside from the historic night last night in Los Angeles, the trade deadline is 24 hours from as we record this. It sounds like there's a trade going on involving the Lakers right now. But what are you hearing as far as the Cavs go and any potential moves they may make between now and Thursday afternoon?
Yeah, they kind of are backing away. It's Wednesday afternoon as we're talking about this. And let's acknowledge that there's, you know, 20-something hours left. It seems like they're backing away from a deal. I think they backed away from a LeVert trade. And I don't think there's ever been anything in Kevin Love. I suppose they could do something smaller. I know they've been linked to Cam Reddish, for example. That, to me, is not an impactful trade. I just don't think they like the market. And I think part of the issue is they don't have picks to trade. And part of the issue is I do think they were in a good position for a Tim Hardaway trade. And the Mavericks did Kyrie Irving, and it changed their positioning. So I definitely think that it could be a quiet deadline for the Cavs. They're playing great right now. They're winning on the road. It's a little bit concerning Garland in popping up with this thumb injury again on the injury list. But they're moving the ball better. Their offense has really come to life. Isaac Okoro, I mean, the Cavs could probably make the argument that if Isaac Okoro is going to shoot this way, there's no reason to go acquire a player. Teams haven't reflected guarding him that way yet, and that there's yet to be an ancillary benefit late in games. But, you know, it's not just 10 days, Isaac Okoro. It's stretching out. So I think that's where they're at. They do have to do something with Caris LeVert. They can't just let him now leave in free agency. They're going to have to do something because if they let that player go away, they can't replace him on the roster. So I'm sure they've gamed that all out. I'm sure they've had discussions with Caris about what he wants to do going forward. I mean, I think if he didn't want to be in Cleveland and they thought they might lose him, that they would definitely have made more of an effort. So it seems to me like Karras probably wants to stay here. There's a decent chance of a new contract or at least a sign and trade in the summer. It could be a quiet deadline, but at the same time, I think the Cavs like where they're at. And, they've moved up into fourth again, and that's a great spot to be in. If they're able to finish there, they get home court in the first round.
Brian, you mentioned the Kyrie trade and how that might, impact the Cavs, Tim Hardaway, but also, I was wondering, could the Cavs sneak in as a third team and try to help some of these things? Like, what do you see the impact of that Kyrie trade on the Cavs, on the Eastern Conference, and certainly where Brooklyn stands right now with some of the things with Kevin Durant?
I don't think Kevin Durant's going to get traded. I don't think his future in Brooklyn is secure. I think the league knows that, and that is why if you have something that the Nets want, why would you trade it now when you could trade it for Kevin Durant? I think that's the sentiment of some teams. Obviously, Durant's not available. Not available yet. Not all teams would do it, but I think that's a factor. But I do think Durant will remain a Net for the short term. And they're super excited about this young guard, Cam Thomas, who scored 40 points in three straight games since Kyrie got traded. We'll see how that goes. But I'm not seeing the teams in front of the Cavs making a lot of moves. The Celtics might make a move for a backup big man. The 76ers might make a move to add someone to their bench. I think ultimately if the Cavs can just continue to play more organized and more confident offense, they have a decent chance of being in good position at the end of the season.
Brian, last thing, I want to go back to LeBron, because when Kareem took the record, people said, oh, that'll never get broken. Well, it did, and we know LeBron's probably got some more time to add a few things, a few more points to that. So, Brian, I'll ask you, put on the spot, do you believe that LeBron's record, wherever it finishes, over 40,000, 41,000, do you ever believe that record will be passed?
Do you think when it gets passed in like 35 years, people will come back and say I was wrong? I listened to the call that the famous and late Lakers announcer Chick Hearn. I listened to the call in like 84, I think, when 83 or 84, when Kareem set the record. And Chick was like, this record will stand for all time, and it wasn't unreasonable. It wasn't unreasonable to think that. And by the way, it stood for 38 years. Pretty good. So I think it's going to stand for a long time. He'll pass 40,000. He intends to make it to when LeBron Jr. can make it to the league. So that's going to be a couple of years at the minimum. Bronny might need 2 years in college. I don't know. He'll put it way past 40 and he'll run away with it for a while. I can't predict the future. It doesn't seem to me like it'll be broken by any player who's active, because I don't see Luka. Plus, he got to start a year early. So you remember about LeBron. He wasn't that great in terms of skills as a rookie. Okay. He didn't shoot the ball real well. He had no 3-point shot. His mid-range shot was shaky. The games were played a lot slower pace back then. 87 points would win you games. And he still averaged 21. So, you got to be awfully good to kind of feel your way into the league and average 21. I think, and then go on for 20 more years. I think he's going to put it in a good spot.
Appreciate it, Brian. Great stuff this weekend. 5 good minutes with ESPN analyst Brian Winters. Of course, next week we will have the trade deadline behind us, so we'll recap everything, and we'll do that next week right here on the ESPN Cleveland social media platforms. This has been 5 good minutes with Wendy.